We've seen how central banks conduct monetary policy, but we need to know the overall impact that it can have on the economy. The effects of monetary policy aren't evident immediately after the central bank conducts its open market operations. It can take up to a few years for the economy to show any changes. In order to lower the overnight loans rate, the central bank first sets a new target, one which is lower than the current one. The central bank then conducts open market operations and buys securities from commercial banks. As we discussed, this puts downward pressure on the overnight loans rate. Once the overnight loans rate falls, other interest rates and the foreign exchange rate falls. The supply of loanable funds increases, and so does the quantity of money in the economy. This is followed by a fall in the long-term real interest rates. The fall in all these interest rates induces an increase in consumption and investment. The fall in the exchange rate that we saw from earlier induces an increase in net exports because domestic goods are now cheaper to foreign buyers. An increase in consumption, investment, and net exports causes aggregate demand to increase. The result is an increase in real GDP and inflationary pressure. In summary, if the central bank conducts expansionary monetary policy in which it lowers the interest rate, real GDP growth follows. When the central bank decides to raise the overnight loans rate, the opposite process takes place. The central bank begins by setting a new, lower target overnight loans rate. It sells securities in an open market operation. This causes other interest rates to rise, and the foreign exchange rate rises as well. The quantity of money and supply of loanable funds eventually decrease, and the long-term interest rate rises. Higher interest rates reduce consumption and investment expenditure, and the higher exchange rate reduces net exports as foreign buyers face relatively higher prices. The combination of reduced consumption, investment, and net exports reduces aggregate demand. When aggregate demand falls, so does real GDP, and either deflationary or reduced inflationary pressure can follow. In summary, an increase in the overnight loans rate causes a slowdown in the growth of real GDP. When the central bank observes a recessionary gap where real GDP is a point below potential GDP and deflationary pressures are affecting the economy, the central bank aims to reduce interest rates in order to boost aggregate demand and restore long-run macroeconomic equilibrium. To do this, the central bank must lower interest rates to reduce investment. As we just saw, in order to lower the overnight loans rate, the central bank must buy securities and increase the supply of bank reserves. With increased reserves, banks create deposits by making loans. This causes the supply of money to increase. Short-term interest rates fall, and the quantity of money demanded increases. Continuing the process from the previous slide, banks create money by making loans. In the short run, this increases the supply of loanable funds, assuming no inflation so that the real interest rate equals the nominal interest rate. In the long run, however, an increase in the supply of loanable funds is matched by a rise in the price level. An increase in the supply of loanable funds lowers the interest rate and thus induces investment. This increases aggregate demand. The multiplier effect kicks in here and raises aggregate demand back to the point of long-run equilibrium. This is the ideal version. The central bank is rarely able to achieve this level of precision where it is able to restore long-run equilibrium. When the economy is facing an inflationary gap, the central bank uses contractionary monetary policy to fight it. This means raising the target overnight loans rate. As we know, in order to achieve this outcome, the central bank must sell its securities to decrease bank reserves. Doing this increases the supply of reserves and raises the overnight loans rate. The money supply also decreases and the quantity demanded of money decreases as well. Short-term interest rates rise. Continuing the process from the previous slide, banks decrease the supply of loans because they have experienced a decrease in their reserves. This is shown by a decrease in the supply of loanable funds curve. The higher interest rate deters investment. This effect is shown by a decrease in aggregate demand. Once aggregate demand is reduced, the multiplier effect kicks in and further reduces the curve until long-run macroeconomic equilibrium is achieved. I want to stress the fact that central banks are generally unable to achieve this level of precision and are normally not able to restore long-run equilibrium with this level of accuracy. That was the lecture on monetary policy.